There's gonna be a party?
I'd guess that the only person who wouldn't show up to a party would be the anonymous Raw GM, because he hasn't shown up to a Raw yet.
Vicky Guerrero,
the Undertaker.
She wouldn't get the right address.
Excuse me!
You think he'd be coming, but then he might not be coming.
Yeah.
Then he might be coming from the ground.
Vince McMahon. I mean, he runs the whole show. He doesn't have to show up if he doesn't want to.
Zack Ryder would be the party crasher.
Zack Ryder.
He's never really invited, but he always shows up and makes a scene anyways.
He thinks he's just so cool, invited to everything. But he's not.
The party crashers would for sure be the Nexus.
Yes.
Nexus. Because they seem to always just show up even when they're not wanted.
I mean, they already crashed the show. Why not parties?
Yeah.
I think Santino would be the ultimate party crasher.
Miz. Because that guy thinks he's the life of the party, and whether he's invited or not, he'll be there because he wants to make sure that everybody sees him.
He's just way too obnoxious. I don't want him around my china.
Person most likely to make a scene after too much spiked eggnog is Vicky Guerrero. Have you seen her Vicky tantrum? I mean, that's without eggnog. Can you imagine what it'd be like with spiked eggnog?
Well, I've seen Nikki off spiked eggnog, so I would have to say Nikki.
John Cena would definitely be the one to make a scene.
Whatever, I don't even like eggnog.
Because it's Christmas every day to him. You just never know what he's gonna do next.
Hornswoggle is definitely the most likely to get wild and crazy.
I definitely think it would be Melina.
I think that Melina would definitely make a scene after drinking spiked eggnog.
Woo! She makes a scene even without eggnog. It'd be fun!
I just have you having a good time, you know, I don't know, dancing like crazy, and who knows what else.
I would like to meet Chris Masters under the mistletoe, because he looks like he's got a lot of practice last year with Eve.
Let's see, I've already been under the mistletoe with the great Kali, with Chris Masters, so why not make it R-Truth? Let's make it three.
Cody Rhodes. I mean, he has good hygiene, and he always has chapstick.
I would love to be under the mistletoe with Daniel Bryan.
Actually, Daniel Bryan would like to be under the mistletoe with me.
Oh, really? Because I think he tried to get me under the mistletoe the other day.
He did it to me the other week.
John Morrison.
Oh, during Thanksgiving?
Yeah, we started early.
The most romantic person I know, Mr. Mark Henry.
I think Alberto Del Rio would be a good gift giver.
Alberto Del Rio, I mean, a Bentley with a bow underneath my tree, I wouldn't mind.
Yeah.
Because he looks like he's got lots of money.
Him underneath my tree with a bow, I wouldn't mind that either.
Natalia's actually a great gift giver.
Probably Natalia.
It's because I'm always buying everybody expensive gifts.
John Cena.
R-Truth.
He's a good guy. He always wants to share everything with everybody.
I think the best gifts are from the heart, and I feel like he could make a really good, like, mixtape.
Lay Cool.
And just rap about you on it.
Because they gave me such a wonderful opportunity by relieving themselves of those precious Divas championships and allowing me to carry them through airport security. Thank you, Lay Cool. Mwah.
Ooh, the Scrooge.
Maurice would be the Scrooge.
That one's kind of an easy one. I would definitely have to say Maurice.
All she thinks about is herself, and she wouldn't want to spend an ounce of her money on anyone else.
The William Regal.
Oh, yeah.
He is, yeah, the Scrooge.
Michael Cole is the Scrooge of the group.
Michael Cole.
He's not got a good thing to say about anyone.
He's the Nightmare Before Christmas.
So he's like the Grinch.
Lay Cool, because they're always complaining and whining about something.
Lay Cool. They would be the person who would tell a kid there's no Santa Claus.
They would take great pleasure in telling someone that there's no Santa Claus.
I could totally see Wade Barrett telling a cute little boy that Santa isn't real.
Oh.
I'd have to say I'd never eat anything that Michael Cole cooked because who knows, it may be poisoned or something.
I would have to say Zack Ryder. Because there's nothing woo-woo-woo-woo about his cooking.
The bad cook of the group is going to be Rosa Mendez because she looks like she can't even boil water.
He seemed like he'd, like, actually put hairspray in his, like, soup.
Yeah, and probably some gel, you know.
Yeah, goop it up.
I would never eat something made by Alicia Fox.
Alicia Fox.
Alicia Fox is the worst cook.
I do not think that girl knows how to cook a thing, not even popcorn.
Because I wouldn't even eat my own cooking. Not even the cereal.
Definitely the food fight would be Hornswoggle.
Oh yeah, for sure.
Hornswoggle.
I could see Hornswoggle starting a food fight, especially with the Divas. He's always trying to cause some sort of trouble.
definitely see Big Show being a food fighter of the group.
Cena, because he threw cake at the last little shindig that we had.
I would have to be the food fighter.
I'm down for a good food fight.
Because I smashed a cake in Vicky Guerrero's face, and I'd like to do it again.